Okay, everybody, today we're going to talk about how to get an APA citation from the database CINAHL. So if you're in a medical class, nursing class, you'll probably be asked at some point to use CINAHL to find some articles. So we found an article here. Now, how are we going to cite this? Now, the database CINAHL can help you with some citations. So what we're going to do, we have this article here. We're going to go right over here where it says cite. See that? Underneath print, email, save, and then we have cite. This is going to help us. So I click there. Now, if you're in a medical class, you're probably going to be asked for APA citation style, not MLA. For writing classes, MLA is very common. Generally for science classes, psychology classes, and just about all medical classes I have worked with, they're going to ask for APA. So we found an APA citation in here. You notice these different styles here. There's MLA if you need that. But for this class, probably you're going to be wanting APA citation. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to highlight this. I'm going to copy it. Then I'm going to go into my Word document I have set up here for my APA citations. The last page of your APA paper, you'll show your references. So we have that set up. Let's just paste this in here. And when we paste it in, it'll look a little strange. The text will all be there, but the formatting will be a little bit off. So you notice it's a little bit off here. So what I would do with this, highlight all this. Let's fix that font first. So it should be Times New Roman, 12 point. Okay. Now we can fix the margins and the spacing here. We can go here to paragraph. See this little arrow by paragraph, click there. Now, see how that indentation is all the way over? That's why it's so far over here. We're going to take that down to zero. Notice it moving and correcting itself down here. Now we're down to zero. Now it should also have a hanging indent, which means the second and third lines, all future lines should be indented over. So we're going to change that to hanging. Should be double spaced, and we're going to tell it don't add any extra spaces to it. Okay, and there we go. So there's the citation set up. Let's take a quick look here. Now this looks like we had a little extra space there. Let's take that out, okay? And let's just take a look. Now some other things I noticed that are wrong here. In APA style, only the first word should be capitalized unless it's a proper noun or a proper adjective. So I'm gonna leave Mexican American, I'm gonna leave those both capitalized, but these other words should not be capitalized if it's APA. So let's take these down here to lowercase. Now, after a colon, we do start the capitalization again, but again, only the first word. So we're going through here, take this off. There's a lot of words here, so it's a long title. And we're going to leave Mexican Americans capitalized. It's a proper word. And this we could take down. This doesn't need to be capitalized. Okay. And then this is the journal that it came from. We can take that of down to a lowercase of. And it shows it's the journal that it came from. That should be italicized. It came from volume 104, issue 8. Here's the pages it was on. Now, this looks a little funny. This is a DOI. This is a digital object identifier. It looks like it's a mistake, but what this is kind of like the serial number of this article. This is an unchanging code affixed to this article. So regardless of what database it comes from or what website, this is the online identifier for this article. With APA, they prefer a digital object identifier. They prefer that over a URL. If we don't have a DOI, we can put a URL in there. But generally speaking, they would like to have a DOI. And most of the articles you're going to find in CINAHL will have DOIs, but some of them won't. So let's try another one. Let's go back here to our result list and let's pull some other articles. So we're going back here and let's pull the second article in the list here. Okay, so we've got the article. Now we go to cite. We find the APA. And I notice something interesting. There's no DOI at the end. So this will be a good example. We're going to copy this and we're going to paste it in. And again, it looks a little strange, but what we can do now, since we set the conditions and the format on this earlier one, we can go here to this little clipboard and click the blue arrow that says Merge Formatting, and it'll copy the format from the first article citation onto the second one. Okay, so it copied these formats onto here, and it took care of a lot of those issues. Let's check it for capitalization. Okay, Nigeria should be capitalized. Now, at the end, we don't have a DOI. So what we have to do now, if it doesn't have a DOI, is type in retrieved from, and we're going to put the first part of the URL. So we've got the URL right up there. We're going to copy that. We're going to paste it, and it's going to put a really big URL here. All we need to do is back to where it says .com, EBSCOhost.com. So let's delete this. And that's all you need there. So now, if you're annoyed by when it creates that into its own little link, you can highlight that, right-click it, and remove hyperlink. So it looks more like just regular text, which is probably, that would probably look better in your paper. Why don't we see if we can grab one more? Just get a little practice doing these. So we're back here, we got the first one, we got the second one. We're gonna scroll down here a little bit. Let's grab this one here. So once again, we go over here to Cite. Let's take a look here. Now this one does have a DOI. It seems like most of them in CINAHL will have DOIs under the APA. So let's grab this, paste this in, and again I'm going to do that little trick on my clipboard here with the merge formatting, and it merges it pretty well. And let's take a look. Now again, it has these, all of these words capitalized, and in APA we don't capitalize all those. So let's just take these down here. Looks like a really interesting article. Long-term aircraft noise exposure and body mass index. Really interesting. I'd like to read that article. So we bring these down. Now after the colon for the subtitle, we start the capitalization over. But just that first word, unless they're proper words. Okay, then we have the journal, which are all capitalized. And the volume, the issue number, the pages, and then the DOI. Okay, so we have a good looking set of references here. The last thing we would need to do is to alphabetize these. Now, a lot of people, the first thing they would want to do is to start cutting and pasting this all over the place. What I would do is just highlight this, highlight the different citations, go up here to A to Z, and then just click OK. And it put them in alphabetical order automatically for us. So that's a quick intro on how to do how to use EBSCO CINAHL database to put together APA citations for you. Let me know if you have any troubles with this.